when you want to identify the diseases in the field, you have to look on the symptoms in the leaves. So you find there is this disease called CGM, cassava green mite disease. It is caused by the green mice. They normally tend to feed on the bottom part of the leaf. Then when they feed on the bottom part of the leaf, they are making it to be more transparent. And that's where you see that there are white patches on the leaves. That is how you identify cassava green mite disease. And in severe infection, it might even make the leaves to curl. But the color is white patches on the leaves. Then the second disease is CMD, cassava mosaic disease. This one is specific. It normally, you find that the leaves will turn yellow. Then when they turn yellow, you'll find that the leaves are curling. So you find that the disease normally starts to attack at the center here when they move towards the periphery. And that's how you identify cassava mosaic disease. There is yellowing of the leaves and also curling of the leaves. Then we have the CBSD, cassava brown stick disease. This one, on the leaves, you'll find that there are patches, yellow patches on the leaves. But it is in between the veins. The leaves tend to look normal. They have not curled. That is the difference between CMD and CBSD. CMD, the leaves are curling, but CBSD, the leaves are not curling, though they are yellowish in color. So that one, you'll find that at the end, when you have put your cassava, you'll find some stripes, patches, like black in color. And that one, it has already caused rotting of the tubers. And tubers that have been attacked by CBSD, they are not even edible. They are so bitter. Yes, so it causes a lot of loss to farmer. And what transfers this disease from one plant to another, we have some specific pests. They are too tiny, and you find some are almost white and some are green. So they are called white fly. The white ones are called white fly. So you find that when there is one disease, when there is one plant on the field that is diseased, either we have the cassava green mite disease, we have the cassava mosaic disease or cassava brown stick disease. When they feed on that leaf, and again flies to the next plant which is healthy and feed on it, it means that they're transferring the disease from one plant to another. That's why we do what is called rogging out. Rogging out is only the removal of diseased plant. You only remove, you uproot and do away with it. And please, when you uproot any diseased cassava, do not leave it on the field, because still there could be further infection in the field. So that's how you control the spread. Then there is a way of preventing. If you want to prevent cassava diseases, you have to use clean certified seeds. And now this is where PlantVillage organization comes up with an AI that helps in scanning and diagnosis of diseases. It can help you. It is a software app that helps you to scan your cassava and identify the disease, then gives you the diagnosis. This one will easily help you to do seed selection. And that's where you come up with now clean cuttings. Then any plant that has already been diseased, do not use it for the cuttings for next season. Just do away with it in the field. Clear everything and do not leave any carcass of that plant on the field. Then we also advise farmers to do what is called crop rotation. Crop rotation helps in controlling the buildup of diseases and pests in the field, and also the maximum use of nutrients in the soil. Yeah. Then that is. You can also plant certain specific crops along the border of the field. For example, we have the napier grass and bracharia or mulatto too. We have the Sudan grass too. When you plant napier grass along your field, it can prevent a lot of things. It can prevent water runoff in the field, and that one, soil erosion, that now it will help to maintain the fertility of the soil. Then when you also plant it along the border, it will prevent pests from invading into your field from another field. Yeah, that is another importance. Then is also source of animal feed. You can also sell it to other farmers. Doesn't mean that you can only plant such grasses in the field when you have the animals, but you can also do it in form to earn you income.